Hi, this is Marco Brigham, and welcome to the first tutorial of Deep Learning Day 2. In this tutorial, we'll cover autoencoders, that are artificial neural networks that learn representations of data by compressing data into a lower dimensionality representation in the bottleneck layer and reconstruct it back into the original dimensionality. So let's call X our inputs, and let's say X is an image, in this case, this cute cartoon on the left. Let's call Z the representation of the input in the bottleneck layer, which we also call latent space, and let's call X tilde the reconstructed output. And we want that the output resembles as closely as possible the input. So this is the basic architecture of the autoencoder that we will see in this tutorial, that has one hidden layer, also called a shallow autoencoder. Now, the autoencoder can still be divided into two components. The encoder component, that goes from the input into the bottleneck layer, and the decoder component, that goes from bottleneck layer into the output. And actually, the autoencoder is a sequence of encoding of inputs into bottleneck layer, and then decoding of bottleneck layer into the output. So here it is, another schema of our autoencoder, where we have the encoder part and the decoder part, corresponding to X on the inputs, to Z on the bottleneck layer, and X tilde the output. Our autoencoder tries to recover the inputs X on the output, and is constrained by representing the inputs into the bottleneck layer that has less units than our inputs and outputs. We'll be working with the amnist dataset. On the top row, you see an example of the inputs, and on the bottom row, the reconstructions from these inputs by a fairly well-trained autoencoder. But how can we visualize Z, the bottleneck layer representation? For this, we introduce two plots, the encoder map and the decoder grid. The encoder map represents each sample by its class digit. In the latent space, the bottleneck layer, here is the y coordinates and here is the x coordinates. So each one of these samples is an image, here x, and the location on the bottleneck layer, Z, is given by a coordinate in the encoder map, and the digit that is representing is the digit class. The decoder grid is a equally spaced grid on bottleneck layer that then is reconstructed back. So we go to bottleneck layer and we take equally spaced intervals in X and Y, and then each one of these points we reconstruct it by feeding it to the decoder. To start getting acquainted with these visualization tools, we go back to PCA and NMF. So recall from the high dimensionality course that both PCA and NMF use matrix factorization and can be used as a linear dimensionality reduction tools. This is the representation of PCA in latent space, where we see that digit class 1 is well separated from digit class 0 in the principal component x is 1, and the other digits are not so well separated in principal component 1, 2, where we see 9s and 7s here on top, 2s and 3s here in the bottom. Similarly, this is the representation of latent space for NMF, whereas we also see some separation for 0s and 1s, but the remaining digits are not very well clustered. Now, we'll compare PCA with our shallow autoencoder. These are two very different techniques. And coming back to this scheme, the autoencoder is a purely nonlinear dimensionality reduction technique. But after comparison, we see that the results are very similar. The autoencoder and PCA, the shallow autoencoder, they mostly separate digits 1 from 0, but it's not very separable for the other digit classes. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial.